So the rain on the roof, it's MCQs we are going to discuss. So the students who are here, the MCQs are there in front of them. So you people can listen. So rain on the roof. The underlying idea of the poem is, the options are, there will be some questions which I'll be drafting from my own side. They are not there in front of the screen. So you all need to write. Write down. Start writing. Keep your notebooks and pens ready. Yes, here also, open up your notebooks and pens. The underlying idea of the poem Rain on the Roof is option number one. Rain makes you remember past. First option is, rain makes you remember your past. Rain makes you remember your past. Second option is, rain is a blessing. Rain is a blessing. Number three, rain brings happy memories of the past. Rain brings happy memories of the past. Number four, rain makes you sleep well. Rain makes you sleep well. Okay, Anshaya, repeat all the options. Okay. So what out of these four is the most appropriate? A was like rain brings past. Na? Rain makes you remember past. But past has got so many things. Do you remember your whole past? No. So according to the poem, it's a blessing. But the poet was not talking about the rain as being a blessing. He was talking about like when you are sleeping in your comfortable bedroom. Then when it rains, then it's a blessing. If you're getting drenched outside, when you cannot protect yourself from rain, it's not a blessing then. But it's the third option was like rain brings happy memories. So yes, the poet was sad. And when rain comes, he's reminded of his mother, the times when his mother used to make him sleep. So that was a happy memory, which is, interacting with his a little bit of sad present. Why sad? Because mother is not there. And fourth option is like rain makes you sleep. It's not always true. And it's not written here. It's not the rain which makes him sleep. It's the memory of the mother which makes him sleep. So the underlying idea of the poem is that rain brings happy memories of the past. So it's not, this option is not always true, mind it. It depends on the kinds of four options you get. Got it? If I had given something else, supposing I had told you write one more option. Just now we have seen that the third option is correct. Now write, add one more option. Then you see like, does your answer remain same? Now the option number five is, Nature soothes, S-O-O-T-H-E-S, nature soothes melancholic heart. Nature soothes melancholic heart. And gives solace. Nature soothes melancholic heart and gives solace. S-O-L-A-C-E. What is solace? Peace. So now Now, what will you say? Now, is the fifth answer correct or third? Fifth is more appropriate. Okay, third was like, yes, third is also very correct. Just know you people, you were saying like third is correct, even I was saying. But now when I've added this option, then I think this is more, you know, about the whole of the poem. Melancholy, melancholic heart. Melancholic means sad. Okay, melancholic means sad. So when somebody is sad, nature makes him happy. So the poet was sad. He was missing his mother. But when it started raining, he started becoming relaxed. And he was able to sleep. It was neither the rain which made him sleep. It was nor the comfortable bed which made him sleep. It was the rain which made him remember mother. And that memory made him have a sleep. So basically, whose role is there? Nature. Nature's role. Nature is acting like a mother. Okay. In the end, rain has brought his memory of mother. So rain is mother then. And what is rain? Rain is nature. Nature is mother. Nature acts like a mother. Nature acts like a teacher. Nature acts like a... Can you give me an example like when I say nature acts like a teacher? Last year in the pandemic, the whole world learned the lesson that we have to take care of nature. And nature taught us. You know, nature taught us to take care of it in its own way. Okay. And what's the meaning of taking care of nature? Living a simple life. Isn't it? Okay. Now write next question. The poetic device used in Starry Spheres is, the poetic device used in Starry Spheres is, wait. Okay, write down four options. Number one, what was I saying? Okay, poetic device. Number one, alliteration, alliteration. First one, I'm saying alliteration. Second one, I'm saying simile. Third one, personification. And fourth one, I'm saying metaphor. So, what is the correct answer out of these four? Yes, Manavi, alliteration. So, this is the correct answer. What is alliteration, Manavi? Which sound? Consonant sound. So repetition of the consonant sound is, repetition of consonant sound in a line is called as alliteration. So here, which sound is being repeated when I say starry spheres? Not S, sound I'm saying, sir. So sir sound is being repeated. This sound, depict the sound like this. Sir sound is being repeated in these two words. So the poetic device used is alliteration. What's the purpose of alliteration in the poem? Yes, Raghav? To make the poem more rhythmic. Okay, anyone? Rhythmic is because of the rhyme. Isn't it? Yeah, it's okay. Anything else? It makes a poem? Huh? Rhythmic, you are saying? Beautiful. Okay. Anything else? Hmm. In Hindi, you might have heard that very common, you know, phrase in alliteration, Chandu ka Chandu ki chachi ne, Chandu ke chacha ko, or something like that. Hana? What was that ch sound was being repeated? Hana? What was that ch sound? Alliteration. So what does that phrase do? What are the tongue twisters? When you go for the tongue twisters, there are alliterations usually. So what's the purpose of alliteration then? Why do you go for tongue twisters? Tongue twisters make you, of course, enjoy language, number one. Second, tongue twisters refine your speech. Third, tongue twisters give a flow to your words. So when the poet is using alliteration in the poem, the words become flowing. Fluency comes. Okay, there is a, if you say rhythm, there cannot be a rhythm if there is no flow. If all the words are in all different consonants, the flow will be obstructed. Okay? Got it? So the alliteration makes that flow smooth and then rhythm comes. Okay, you should know like why the poets are using these kinds of things. Not just the poet knows alliteration, so he has to use it. The way you people do in making a poem. You know like there has to be a rhythm, rhyme, and you make the rhyme possible by hook or by crook. Some people do that. Okay, anyways, so it was alliteration in Starry Spheres. What's the meaning of Starry Spheres? Night full of stars or sky full of stars? Sky full of stars. So here spheres refer to sky. Spheres refer to sky. Sky which is full of stars. Okay. Do you think there is some other poetic device in Starry Spheres? Try to apply your mind. I told you there is one more poetic device. Huh? Very good. Silent clap for 9C. Especially for some children, those who answered it. Yeah, very good. It's a star. It's a transferred epithet. How do I say that this is transferred epithet, Jia? Why is it transferred epithet? Are you Jia? Are you Jia? So his name is Jia. No? Yes. What's your name? Huh? Gurshan. Gurshan. Yeah, sincere boy. Yes, Jia. Yes, you are right. Because starry actually is the adjective of sky. Sky is starry, not all spheres. Starry refers to sky. But here the writer is saying spheres. Okay? Got it? So when the adjective refers to a noun other than the one which is mentioned here, we call that adjective as transferred epithet. Epithet means adjective. Epithet means adjective. When the epithet refers to some other noun other than the one which is given, we call it transferred adjective, transferred epithet. So this is also an example of transferred epithet. Okay, will you be able to identify transferred epithets anywhere? Okay, so now write on fifth option, transferred epithet. Yes, Lavanya, write down transferred epithet. Now what will you do? You've got two options. Both will not come. Options may nahi aise. Haan. If I write down first. Write on first transferred epithet. Transferred epithet. Now I'm giving you options. Now your options A is, this was like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now your MCQ is, you have to choose the right option. A option is option number 1 and 2. ऑप्शन नंबर 1, 4 एंड 5, ऑप्शन नंबर 3, 4 एंड 5, ऑप्शन नंबर 1 एंड 5. सो व्हाट इज करेक्ट लावण्या? 1 एंड 5. सो नॉट 1 एंड 5, डी ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट. व्हाट्स योर आंसर? डी. सो यू विल बी मार्किंग डी ऑप्शन इन योर ओएमआर शीट इन द पेपर. Okay, you'll be getting an OMR sheet in the exams. Do you know this?
Yes,
ma'am. And in the OMR sheets, you have to write the correct options. So don't get confused like here 1 and 5 is correct. So you'll be ticking 1 and 5. Okay, that's a question. And the options are from here. And you have to choose the correct option, that is D. Got it? Okay, now next question. Did you see the blackboard, children? I guess yes. Next question is, what is melancholy darkness? What is melancholy darkness, writer? All the online students also keep writing the questions, because I'm not giving any question from the screen given there. What is melancholy darkness? Yeah, what is melancholy darkness? Options are, number 1, sad darkness. Number 2, the darkness which has made the poet become sad. Number 3, poet's sadness. Number 4, dark clouds. Yes, sir, Hirde. What's the B option? What is that? I don't remember like which options I've given you. Tell me, ma'am, this is the answer. Okay, how many you people are sitting? 19. Do I have 38 years? Will you speak one by one? Or no? Yes, sir. Correct answer. Again, the same thing. Give the answer. Sad. So darkness has made the poet sad. Sad darkness, Janvi? Are you giving this answer? Manavit, you are saying sad darkness. How can the darkness be sad? Have you ever seen darkness saying, I'm very sad? But it's not the meaning sad darkness. I'm not asking you whether it's a personification or not. That is the poetic device. That is the meaning which we are to infer. But we can't say like, ma'am, melancholy darkness means sad darkness. It's a mathematical answer. In maths, you say 2 + 2 = 4. Bas, baat khatam. In English, it is not so. In English, you have to say 2 + 2 = sometimes 22 also. Okay, poets can say anything. Yes. Free-minded. Yeah, they have a license. What kind of license they have? What license is given to the poets? Poetic license, we call it. Which license? Poetic license. It gives them freedom. They can change the spellings of the words to make their poem meaningful. Okay. So I was asking you poetic, what was the word? Melancholy darkness means, yes, raise hand now. Yes, Janvi. repeat. Yes, the darkness which has made the poet become sad. Do you agree or not? Yes, out of these four options, this is correct. The darkness which has made the poet become sad. Okay, now write fifth option also. And you will see that your answer will change. No, I don't guarantee. Maybe not. So fifth option is, did I give the option like dark clouds?
Yes.
Okay, was that wrong? That is wrong? Dark clouds. Is that wrong? Okay, dark clouds. Okay, now right. The clouds seem to be dark. Sorry, the clouds seem to be sad. The clouds seem to be sad as they are laden with, tears. As they are laden, L-A-D-E-N. The clouds seem to be dark as they are. The clouds seem to be sad as they are laden with tears. In bracket, you can write on water. As they seem to be, sad because they are full of water or tears. Now, is this answer wrong? Even this is correct. Why does the poet say that the clouds are weeping? Because they are, they are full of water, moisture, and for the poet, that moisture is like tears. And those tears fall on the earth. Okay. So does the idea, is the idea conveyed that the nature is crying with the poet? The nature shares human beings' sorrow. The poet was sad and he thinks that even the nature is also sharing his sorrow with him. Got it? So see the underlying ideas of the poem. So many things the poet wants to say. Getting? So it depends upon the kind of options you have got, which you have to pick the correct one. So I want to say, like, just one thing in your mind which you have crammed will not help you solve your answers or MCQs in the papers. It is very easy to write an answer in about 30 to 40 words, but very difficult to tick one option which is given correct out of the four ones, because all the options will seem to be correct. Okay, MCQ doesn't mean that one option correct and other three wrong. No, it means that one option is very correct and the other three options are distractors. What is the meaning of distractor? That is just telling you to go here and there. When you go somewhere, when you're going on a road, when you are driving on one particular road, and at one point, a fork comes. Either be road. Then you stop your car and you start thinking, idhar ki udhar. Imagine you don't have any GPS. And sometimes even GPS fails in that kind of situation. Did you ever experience? So imagine you don't have GPS and you have to take one route, either here or there. Then you have to apply your all logic. Because doesn't mean that one road is totally wrong. Maybe through the other road also the way might come, but that might not be a shortcut. For example, if you are coming from Phagwada to Jalandhar, the road is hardly for 20 minutes. But if you are taking an off route, then you reach after 3 hours. But road came from that side also. So the off route via Phagwada is a distractor, which you take from Jandiala side. That is a distractor. And the main route is Phagwada to Jalandhar for only 20 minutes. Similarly, in the MCQs, one is the main answer and the others are distractors. Distractor mein pad gaye toh in exam 0, or if you are on the road, then instead of reaching in 20 minutes, you'll reach after 3 hours. It is like the road not taken. So MCQs are like road not taken. Right? In all subjects, not just in English. Okay? So I'm not scaring you. I'm just telling you to change your mindset about studies. Now study is no more about cramming and learning a few things. It's about becoming thoughtful. Thoughtful honge to baat ban jayegi. And earlier also it was so. Earlier it was not that education wanted you people to become crammers. But earlier in exams you people could go through, thereby becoming crammers. But now only cramming will not help you. And you will see there will be big changes in the results. The children, those who were thoughtful but could not cram, they will come forward now. So big competition, tough competition. And the children who used to be at the top slot earlier, they were at the top slot because they could think also and they could cram also. Okay, but now basically the thoughtful people will be coming ahead. So the already those who were the toppers, for them a little bit of tough competition. Getting? So there are many thoughtful children sitting around. They will also come forward. Am I right? So you have to be thoughtful. Is it easy or difficult? What do you say? Easy or difficult? Huh? Easy. Why easy? Why? Because God has made us naturally thoughtful. Okay, God has naturally made us thoughtful. We can think, but what happens? We don't think. When you're going on a road, when you're going somewhere, as I told you earlier, on the way, what happens? If you get stuck on a fork, you stop your car, you think, or do you have to ask somebody like, do I have to think? You think, naturally you think. And after thinking, you take one route. Sometimes you are wrong. Never mind. You come back and go to the right side. But you think, that is what is required now. Bas. If something is wrong, never mind. It's okay, take it easy. Okay, if you get some answers wrong, never mind. That will help you become more insightful. Okay? Right? So no need to be distressed. Okay, write down some more questions. I don't know. Time is running out. Okay. So write one more question. As I list to this refrain, dash, dash, dash. Here list refers to, number one, making a list. Number two, listening. Number three, speaking. Number four, writing. Writing. So what's the correct answer? Yes, beta, you tell. Second last. Huh? Yes? Okay, I am saying that number one, it was making a list. Second, listening. Third, reading. Fourth, writing. Now give answer. Come on. Look at me. So when I list. Listen. look at me. When I list to this refrain, what is the refrain? What is the refrain? Huh? You tell better. Song, yes. I don't know what others were saying. So, yes, Hirdayji. Listening, yes. So here list refers to listening, right? List refers to listening. Poets have got the poetic license. They can make listen as list. Okay. So anyways, tomorrow we'll continue with something else. Today's lecture was dedicated to teach you how to study. Okay. It was not dedicated to give you MCQs. Okay.